thank you very much for coming. I would like to welcome the students and the professors from the Courtauld Institute of Art. And I would like to thank Sarah Wilson and Adrian Sina for arranging the talk for me. I would like to welcome students from the Berbeck College as well. I will mention why in a moment. And I would like to welcome Marisa Lewandowska, who is here in the audience, who is a very famous British-Polish artist who participated in one of my exhibitions almost 20 years ago. So I studied at the Courtauld. It was 25 years ago or longer. I was an occasional A student. And so this is what is going to happen to you if you are going to be an occasional student. You are going to create weird exhibition in funny places, and then you're going to have a talk during the lunch break. So better pay the full price. So I'm very happy to be back at the Courtauld always, even though for a couple of years I work at the University of Sussex in Brighton, and I am mentioning it because while working there in the Center for Sexual Dissidence, this is an academic unit with this kind of strange name, but it has existed at the University of Sussex almost for 35 years. And when I was working there, I co-curated with John David Rhodes a series of symposia on queer curating at Brighton Museum and Art Galleries. And it was in 2012-2013, long ago before the exhibition at Tate Britain in 2017, which queered to some extent the National Museum of Britain. So today I'm going to talk about queering the national museums internationally, from the international perspective, and I will mention my show a little bit because this is a very significant exhibition when it comes to the national museums. So the exhibition Ars Homoerotica, which I've organized at the National Museum in Warsaw, was organized in 2010. It was a completely different time in Poland, because Poland as a country in Central Eastern Europe, but still in the European Union, which this country is not. So Poland is still in a better position, but unfortunately, right now it's run by a far-right party. But when the exhibition was organized in 2010, it was run by a relatively liberal right-wing party, so that is why the show was possible. I am mentioning the political climate, because the political context is essential for queer exhibitions anywhere, not only in Central Eastern Europe, because in many countries, especially in Europe, the national museums are completely dependent on public funds, on so-called federal money or money from the state. And of course, the state is regulated by political forces. And that is why every exhibition, especially exhibition on difficult subject, political subject, contested subject, which is organized in the National Museum, is heavily censored always or controlled by the governments, because it depends on the public money. And it was the case in Poland in 2010, at the time when a relatively liberal right-wing party was in power. That is why the exhibition was possible there in 2010. It would be completely impossible right now in 2020 when the country is run by a far-right party where homophobia is the official policy of the party. So when I'm talking about the exhibition, I'm always having this kind of strange memory trip to a moment in the history of my country which was much better, much more liberal than it is right now, and it shows how quickly the historical situation can change when it comes to human rights. So the exhibition at the National Museum in Warsaw was possible only because the director at the time, Piotr Piotrowski, wanted me to organize the exhibition. Piotr Piotrowski and Karolina Murawska-Mutezius, they were directors of the National Museum. Karolina Murawska-Mutezius is a Polish-British art historian working at Verbeck College in London, and that is why I welcome students from Verbeck College as well. So they wanted me to organize a queer exhibition at the National Museum. So the only way what you can do this kind of exhibition in a major institution is when you are invited, of course, by the institution and by the directors in this institution to do this kind of project, because I am personally a freelance curator. I don't work on a permanent basis in any institution. I am an academic, so I teach curatorial studies, and I teach queer studies in art history and contemporary LGBT queer art globally. And when I'm invited, I curate exhibitions. And happily enough, I have been invited many times to do my project, and this is one of my projects. So because of the director, Piotr Piotrowski, who was a very liberal and very generous and very knowledgeable art historian of Central and Eastern European art, who became director at the time, I was able to organize the exhibition. Because Piotr Piotrowski, I have to mention his name again, he developed a concept of a critical museum. A critical museum that he wanted to implement while being the director at the National Museum in 2010. This is one of his books that are translated in English. And this is a book that was edited by Katarzyna Moraska-Muterysz and Piotr Piotrowski, From Museum Critique to the Critical Museum, which elaborates on the concept of critical museum that that he developed, and thanks to it, I was able to queer the National Museum of Poland. So a couple of words about the concept of the critical museum. I am going to focus, when I speak like this, can you hear me?
Yeah.
I am going to focus on a very particular institutions and curating in a very particular institutions about the national museums, because from the history of curating and the history of exhibitions, we know that queer, LGBTQ, gay, lesbian, whatever you want to call it, exhibitions have been organized internationally since the 70s in the so-called Western world, and in Central Eastern Europe, first queer exhibitions in galleries, in independent centers were appearing in the 80s. So there is a very long history of this kind of shows in private galleries, in contemporary art institutes, in modern art institutes, but the National Museum is a completely different case. It's much more difficult case to do this kind of show in the National Museum, even though the National Museum is a perfect location for the queer exhibition. It's the best location ever that you can have. Why? Because the National Museums are usually so-called general survey museums or so-called encyclopedic museums. So in their collection, they have artworks or examples of visual culture from all historical periods, from the antiquity up until today. And not only art, but also design and some examples of visual culture. So they have extremely rich historical material that as a curator you can work with. And usually this is the situation with the National Museums, with modern art museums, contemporary art museums. You have, of course, collections of contemporary or modern art, but you don't have the historical material. But what is fascinating to work from the queer point of view is getting access to the works from the Baroque, from Renaissance, from medieval times, and then to put it in context with contemporary visual culture and with contemporary attitude. This is what is fascinating when you do a general survey queer show in the National Museums, and that is why National Museums as places which hold this kind of major historical collections are the best to do this kind of extensive queer exhibitions. But at the same time, they are the most difficult to get into for a variety of reasons. Of course, the first reason is nationalism. It's not only in Europe, but internationally. Nationalism as a concept was established in the 19th century, and from the very beginning, it was very strongly intertwined with the national museums. When the national museums were being established in the 19th century, early 19th century, it depends on a country, it was always somehow connected with the construction of national identity. And we know from the history of Western culture that the national identity, it has been usually very heteronormative. It was a very heteronormative construct, and it is up until today. So there is always this connection between nationalism, heteronormativity, and of course this impacts on the construction, on the thinking about the national museums. Quite often the national museums are considered also as places of quite bourgeois culture, a culture that is connected with some kind of elites, with high cultural values, with high artistic values, and for a very long time, queerness, surprisingly enough, was not part of this kind of attitudes and thinking about art. Queerness belonged to something that was unconscious, that was objective, that was repressed, that was not part of the mainstream. And national museums were considered a very mainstream institution. That is why queerness and very open expression of homoeroticism or transgender issue had no place there. And the third reason is that because they are run by the cultural elites. And the cultural elites, and this is true in almost every country, especially in Europe, tends to be rather conservative. And this is another reason why queer exhibitions are difficult to organize in the national major encyclopedic museums. And there's always a money question. Of course, getting money, and it has been a problem for many curators trying to queer national museums, is very difficult for this kind of project in the national museums, much more difficult than in contemporary and modern art museums. So when Piotr Piotrowski became the director of the National Museum in Warsaw, he's a modern and contemporary art curator and historian, and from the very beginning, his vision of the National Museum was that it is not going to be an institution of national heritage. It is not going to be an institution of established values. It is not going to have anything to do with nationalism or Polishness or whatever, even if it was in the National Museum of Poland, but a vision of the National Museum that deals with burning cultural and social issues. This was his approach. Museum as a place for free debate, socially engaged museum, through both historical and contemporary art, showing the art of democracy for democracy. So this is his concept of a critical museum, not as a place of national heritage, not of conservative value, not of preservation the cultural heritage, but a place that is like an agora, like a Greek agora, that enables us to think freely about current burning social and political issues, not only through contemporary art, but also through historical art. And that is why having a queer exhibition that deals with the history of homosexuality in the entire history of culture, and at the same time it is an issue which is very politically topical in many parts of Europe at the time, especially in Eastern Europe, and this combination of critical approach to museology and at the same time political relevance make him to want to have this kind of exhibition at the National Museum.